Hello everyone. So in this video we have been discussed regarding the derivative part of electromagnetic fields with respect to electric field intensity identification with respect to the line charge, surface charge and volume charge derivations. So here, so in the past videos we have seen the electrostatic field and Coulomb's law, the force identification between the charges. So here in that video we have seen the electrostatic field, that is the electric field intensity E bar value, that is equal to integral rho L dl by 4 pi epsilon naught r square into ar. This is the electric field intensity for the line charge. Then electric field intensity E bar for the surface charge rho s ds divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square into ar. This is for surface charge, and electric field intensity for volume charge rho v dv by 4 pi epsilon naught r square into ar. This is for volume charge. So we have been identified the electric field intensity for different charge distributions, line, surface and volume charges. Now in order to get the value, once this charge distribution has been applied with respect to coordinate systems, then we need to get the respective electric field intensity for the different charge distributions. So those derivative parts we will see one by one, starting with the line charge. So let's move to the first charge distribution, line charge distribution, to identify the value of electric field intensity. Here if we see this figure, here the point charge has been placed, okay, on the z axis, and it has been distributed, let it through the line of A to B with charge density rho L extending from A to B, and has been placed along the z axis, and it is shown in this figure here. And we are going to identify the electric field intensity at some point P, let it be here this point. So with respect to this point we need to identify the electric field intensity. So with respect to this point, the field towards, which is parallel to y-axis, seems to be d e rho, and which is parallel to the z-axis seems to be differential element d e z, and the resultant of these two will have d e. And if we make a line joining from the small element that is considered between from point A to B, a very small element which is called dl, and that point is considered to be 0 comma 0 comma z dash, and line joining from dl to P, point P, is called r, and projecting a line onto the z axis from point P, which makes a distance which is called rho, this rho is equated to circular cylindrical coordinates, and line joining from B to P and A to P. So angles made for these three different line joins seems to be considered as alpha 2, alpha and alpha 1. Now evaluating of electric field intensity due to the line charge distribution, the charge has been distributed along the z axis. Now the charge element is very small, which is considered as dq, and it is associated with element dl. Now the dl is exist along the z axis, now that is considered equated to dz. And if we equate this line with respect to charge distribution, that is a charge element, we have been equated to dq is equal to rho l dl. And here the l is, I mean the line l is along the z axis, so change the term, differential term, dl is equated to dz. And To get the total charge that exists along the z-axis, integrate on both sides. We will get the value q equal to integral along the z-axis ZA point to ZB rho L dz. Here we got the value only the total charge. Now with respect to the previous screen which is shown here, electric field intensity for the line charge rho L dl by 4 pi epsilon naught r square ar. Using this here, if we equate this rho L dl, remaining terms has to be substituted. In this case, to get the value of electric field intensity at some point P, here at some point P which is called the XYZ, and the electric field point is considered, field point is considered as X comma Y comma Z, and source point is considered as X dash, Y dash and Z dash, and that is represented here at DL. It is X dash and Y dash is zero because the point exists on Z axis, and DL is equated to DZ dash. And with respect to the electric field intensity of the previous screen equation, we need to identify the remaining terms or the parameters, that is R and AR by R square. So R can be written as here equal to X, Y, Z minus 0, 0, Z dash, which can be written in terms of equation X, A, X plus Y, A, Y plus Z minus Z dash, Z minus Z minus Z dash into A, Z. So here from the addition vector, we can write this total term in a simplified manner as R dash R bar equal to rho A rho plus Z minus Z dash into A Z. Now here this term X A X plus Y A Y is completely obtained to be rho into A rho using the addition vector from this figure. Once again, to get the magnitude of this R, let's take the magnitude R, then R square equal to X square plus Y square plus Z minus Z dash whole square. That is equated to, once again in terms of circular cylindrical coordinates, rho square plus Z minus Z dash whole square. Take the division part of the unit vector with the R square term, then we will get R bar by R cube. That is equated to, R bar can be written as rho A rho plus Z minus Z dash into A Z divided by rho square plus Z minus Z dash whole square all to the power of 3 by 2. Now, with respect to the electric field intensity E bar, we obtained one of the term is AR by R square, that is R bar by R cube. If you see the first screen, see here, E bar equal to, for the line charge rho L dl by 4 pi epsilon r square. So this term we have obtained from the figure that line charge exists along the z axis. Now let's look into that. Substituting these terms there, we can get another expression with the value of E bar on the left hand side, rho L by 4 pi epsilon naught integral rho A rho plus Z minus Z dash into A Z divided by rho square plus Z minus Z dash whole square into whole to the power of 3 by 2 into D Z dash. So here we need to change the entire function integral function z dash to other term. As with respect to figure, the entire function is with respect to angles to get the distribution of the charge density at the point P. With respect to line joining of BP, L, DLP and AP, we need to change the differential terms to be D alpha. Then change the differential term to alpha. Then we will get like this, R square equal to rho square plus z minus z dash whole square. This is the term which we have been seen from here. Then change this term to other value. From the figure, we can write some trigonometric equations. Secant alpha equal to R by rho, which in term we can write in terms of R, that is R equal to rho secant alpha. Then from figure, once again, sine alpha equal to z minus z dash by R, that is equated to R equal to z minus z dash by sine alpha. And from figure, cos alpha also we can write, which is nothing but rho by R. And we can write tan alpha equal to z minus z dash by rho, which in term simplify this one, we can write z dash equal to z minus rho tan alpha. And this z I can write with the other value, that is OT minus rho tan alpha. This term OT is mentioned only to identify that the z is constant, to mention. That is nothing else, there is nothing intention in this to change the z into OT in order to represent that this term is completely independent of the function differentiation or the integration. Just to see here, z is present here, z term is present here. This is the O, that is the origin. From here to here, it is a OT, which is equal to z. That is completely constant. So this term, to get, as you need to get the dz, differentiate this value, then you can get dz dash equal to minus rho secant square alpha d alpha. Then now interchange all the terms of E equation here, interchange all the terms of this z terms into alpha, then we can get E bar equal to minus rho L by 4 pi epsilon naught over the angle of alpha 1 to alpha 2 we will get. And in here, dz dash can be written as minus rho secant square alpha d alpha. And the remaining term is rho a rho is written. Here, the term rho a rho is written as it is, plus z minus z dash term is written as rho tan alpha into a z. The denominator term is completely written, that is rho square plus z minus z dash. This complete term is written as rho secant square alpha. So even that can be seen here, that is rho square plus r plus z minus z dash whole square is equal to r square. That is equated to rho secant alpha. This term is completely squared. Then we can get rho secant square alpha whole to the power of 3 by 2. Then the simplified equation we will get, overall this tan can be written as sine by cos. So overall the simplified equation we will get with a single step, rho L by 4 pi epsilon. So So this minus has taken outside, minus rho L by 4 pi epsilon naught. So denominator term we will get rho, the square will get cancelled here, we will get cube, and in this cube two terms will get cancelled here. Then we will get the terms alpha 1, alpha 2 integration cos alpha a rho plus sin alpha a z into the differential term d alpha. Here this is the term of electric field intensity for the line charge over the interval for the angle alpha 1 to alpha 2. So if we want, we can apply the integration, then we will get the equation rho L by 4 pi epsilon naught rho, then minus of sin alpha 2 minus sin alpha 1 into a rho plus cos alpha 2 minus cos alpha 1 into a z. So from this we can have the special case also, we can get it. That is, if we replace the terms of alpha 1 to be pi by 2, extreme cases we can take alpha to be minus pi by 2, then the z term will completely vanishes from this expression. Then the final expression we will get for the line charge, the electric field intensity will be E bar equal to rho L by 2 pi epsilon naught rho into a rho. So here, if the line is not along the z-axis, rho is perpendicular to the line, to the point of interest, and a rho is a unit vector here along the distance directed from the line charge to the field point. Next, we will see the surface charge to identify the electric field intensity. So here, let's look into surface charge to identify the electric field intensity. So as we need to identify the electric field intensity with respect to surface charge, we need a plane, not a line. So with respect to this, there is a consider some surface or the plane which is exist on the xy plane. Two points has been considered on this plane, and there is a reference point P has been considered, and it is located along the z-axis. And this is the point where the field E bar electric field intensity is going to be identified with respect to these two points on the plane of xy. And this is the surface charge density rho s. From this figure we are going to identify the electric field intensity. Now this infinite sheet of charge in the xy plane with rho s, the differential element ds is considered, and charge element, differential charge element can be written rho s ds, and total charge q equal to integral rho s ds. With respect to the contribution of this E bar of point P 0, 0, h, with respect to this surface, I can write the differential electric field intensity is dE equal to dQ by 4 pi epsilon naught r square into ar. Let this be equation 1. So in order to get this parameters, that is ar by r square, we will consider this figure. Let us have some equations, then we can get the substitute all those terms to get the total electric field intensity. From figure, using the addition vector, we can write the total value of r. So this is the value of r, and this is the height h from origin to p, and from 1 to 2 it is a distance is rho. Okay, from origin to point 1 is rho, and this r reverse side 0 to 2 is also rho. See here, from figure using the addition vector, I can write r plus rho a rho equal to h a z. R can be written once again rho of minus AZ minus A rho, sorry, minus A rho plus H AZ. This term, if we take the magnitude of R, then we can get the value rho square plus H square whole to the power of 1 by 2. For the magnitude, unit vectors will be, take the product as 1. Then dq is get rho s ds. Ds is the surface differential element. So we will get the differential elements 2 for the surface. So then rho s, the surface is exist with respect to xy plane. Then we can get rho d rho and the angle with respect to point P is d phi. So substituting all these terms in electric field, differential electric field intensity, dE we will get as rho s rho d phi d rho into rho d rho plus h az divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into rho square plus h square whole to the power of 3 by 2. So from this, there is some observation we need to talk about, that with respect to the figure, there is some symmetry existence on the surface charge distribution for the element 1 with respect to element 2. The A rho term will cancel that of element 1 with respect to element 2. Thus, the term E rho, the term E rho will add up to the term becomes 0. So E bar has only, that is the differential term E bar has only Z component, not the rho component. Then, so with respect to mathematical, replacing the term A rho with the transformations of the unit vector transformations, we can write A rho as cos phi AX plus sin phi AY. Integration of this term for the range 0 less than phi less than 2 pi, it also gives to be 0. Then we will get the final value of E rho with integration this term. Then we will get integral d Ez equal to rho s by 4 pi epsilon naught. However, the term H is also constant. We will take the term H, and here the term with respect to symmetry in nature, the term A rho E get cancelled, which is 0. Then we will get only Az term, that is written here rho. Then the integral parts, as it is a surface, phi term will be 0 to 2 pi. Then another integral, rho equal to 0 to infinity as infinite sheet of charge. And we will get the term, remaining terms, rho d rho d phi. Denominator term will be as it is, rho square plus h square whole to the power of 3 by 2 into Az. Here, in order to simplify the integration very smoothly, we will change the differential term of d rho into some other function like d rho square by taking the scaling factor of this entire equation with 1 by 2, 1 by 2. That is, I'll give a simple idea that rho square in differentiation we will get 2 rho. Then if that already this term is a dependent term, then we will get d rho. Like that, if we substitute along with the scaling factor of 1 by 2 rho square, then we will get 1 by 2 rho 2 rho d rho, which the two term will be gets cancelled. Then we will get the term rho d rho as it is with respect to this expression. Now I will change this zero term into the additional change of the expression with the differential element d rho square. Then I can get like this, that is equal to, that is E z term is equal to rho h by the rho s suffix, rho s h by 4 pi epsilon naught. Here the phi is completely independent of any of the function inside the integration, so I can remove the integration of the phi. Then I will get 2 pi for the term, then the remaining term 0 to infinity rho square plus h square all to the power of 3 by 2 1 by 2 d rho square into az. So removing integration by taking the dependent term only, rho square with respect to this differential function, then we can get rho s h by 2 epsilon naught minus of rho square plus h square whole to the power of minus 1 by 2 with the interval of 0 to infinity az. Simplifying this equation, I can get rho s by 2 epsilon naught az. So this equation with respect to z term, I mean placing the infinite sheet onto the xy plane, obviously resultant of the surface is always normal, so that is the normal is z condition here. So this equation can be written in a generalized manner with the electric field intensity E bar equal to rho s by 2 epsilon naught with the general equation normal an. Here an is normal to the sheet. Next we will see the volume charge distribution for identifying the electric field intensity. Now let's continue with the volume charge. Here if you see this figure, there is a sphere has been considered. So it's a volume sphere charge where the charge is completely distributed through this entire sphere. Through the entire sphere we have been considered a very small differential volume which will be helpful to identify the electric field intensity at point P, which is located at point 0 comma 0 comma z, and this sphere is with made the azimuthal angle phi dash. With respect to this point or the differential volume, made an elevation angle theta dash, and the distance from origin O to this dv is r dash, small r dash, and this charge density, volume charge density, is rho v, and angle made from point P with respect to z axis with respect to dv is alpha. These are the terms, and a dv differential volume at the point is r dash, theta dash and phi dash. R dash is the distance, the point with respect to differential volume with respect from the origin. From the figure I can write some terms with using the trigonometric functions. Sin alpha I can write by rho by capital R, and cos alpha is equal to z by 2 by R. Here z by 2, get it, is the total from P to O is z. Among these I am taking this triangle alone, then I can get this value as z by 2. So this is the alpha, cos alpha adjacent side by hypotenuse. And other term is differential charge, volume charge. Using with respect to volume charge, I can get dq equal to rho v dv, and taking the integration q equal to integral rho v dv, and simply to write rho v with the total volume charge, I can write for the sphere 4 pi a cube by 3. So this is the 4 pi a cube by 3 is the sphere volume that has been considered. Now this charge I need to relate with respect to electric field intensity, identifying at P with respect to differential volume. Let's take the differential electric field intensity dE bar equal to rho v dV by 4 pi epsilon naught r square into AR. From this, using the unit vectors representation, I can write unit vector AR as cos alpha AZ plus sin alpha A rho. Here the same concept we can implement as the surface charge distribution has a symmetry, volume charge also has symmetry of charge distribution. With respect to the contributions of Ex or Ey, which makes add up to zero due to the Ez considerations. So Ez I can write as E bar into Az, and Ez I can write with the integration differential element dE cos alpha. This is how I get as this term, I get like using the dot product of these two terms. This is term one, term two, dot product AB cos alpha, like that A dot A bar dot B bar equal to AB cos theta, like that I get E bar, that is a differential element dE integration, then A cos alpha, I wrote it. And unit vector will be magnitude as 1. Then Ez equal to so this term I can write substituting all the respective terms of dE. Just now we have seen in the previous in this screen itself, that is Ez equal to rho v by 4 pi epsilon naught into r square, integral dV cos alpha, which is equation 1, that is considered here, equation 1. Now dV is written with respect to spherical coordinate system, differential volume I can write with r dash square sin theta dash dr dash d theta dash d phi dash. Here this three terms we got as it is a volume required, three differential terms. So from the figure we can write some other terms, that is sin theta dash equal to rho by r dash. So from the figure we can write the same terms. Let us write once again. Sin theta dash, that is the elevation angle, this angle, now this angle I have been considered, sin theta dash equal to rho by r dash, cos theta dash equal to z by 2 by r dash. Now using the addition vector of r, the same term we can get r square equal to rho square plus z by 2 whole square, taking considering the magnitude itself along, then rho square plus z by 2 can be written z minus z by 2. Simply I can write rho as from this equation, rho as r dash sine theta dash whole square plus z minus z by 2 as written as r dash cos theta dash whole square. Simplifying this equation overall, we can get r square r in terms of r square, you can write r square equal to z square plus r dash square minus 2z r dash cos theta dash. Similarly, the other terms using the alpha angle, upper triangle, sin alpha is rho by r, cos alpha is z by 2 by r. The same terms to get small r dash square the term r dash square, we can get equal to z square plus r square minus 2 z r cos alpha. So from these two terms, taking the left hand side cos term in terms of theta dash and alpha, we can write cos theta dash equal to z square plus r dash square minus r square by 2 z r dash, and cos alpha can be written as z square plus r square minus r dash square by 2 z capital R. Now, with respect to substitution of equation 1, we need cos alpha and differential volume dv has sine theta dash dr dash d theta. As we got cos theta dash, to get the sine theta dash, differentiate the term, this one, this term has been differentiated. We need differentiate this term to get sine theta dash. Then I can get sine theta dash equal to, d theta dash equal to r by dr by z r dash. As with respect to this theta, the term, remaining terms will be constant. That is z dash, z and r dash is constant, fixed. Substituting all the necessary equations, that is cos alpha and sine theta dash d theta dash in dv in equation 1, you can get the electric field intensity towards the z axis is rho v by 4 pi epsilon naught integral phi term leads to 0 to phi dash term leads to 0 to 2 pi. As there is no dependent terms, it is a constant. It is a unit, only one term will be the unit, only numerical value 1 will be there. And r dash will be 0 to a, and capital R will be, that is the last, theta dash will be z minus r dash z plus r dash r dash square r dr divided by z r dash into dr dash. Into the cos alpha term is substituting to get z square plus r square minus r dash square by 2 z r into 1 by r square. So in simplifying these equations, we will get the equation as Ez equal to rho v 2 pi divided by 8 pi epsilon naught z square. Obviously, phi dash term, there is no dependent terms. So integration has been removed, applying with 1, 0 to a r dash. Capital R is z minus r dash by z plus r dash into r dash into 1 plus z square minus r dash square by capital R square into dr dr dash. Making some simplification with respect to this, we can get rho v into pi divided by 4 pi epsilon naught z square. Integral 0 to a r dash into capital R minus of z square minus r dash square by capital R with the interval z minus r dash into z plus r dash. Substituting these terms, intervals, into this fact, into this scaling factor, then I can get the value overall rho v into pi divided by 4 pi epsilon naught z square into 0 to a 4 r dash whole square dr dash. That is equated to, that is been equated to, once again, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. This term is completely written with respect to sphere volume. You can write 1 by z square with 4 by 3, this r dash square, we can get default. I am writing with respect to the similar equation, which is equated to volume. I'm writing rho v. So this term r dash square integration r dash cube by 3. So overall, I am rearranging the terms to get which is equated to sphere volume. So final equation with respect to z, I can get electric field intensity Ez equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught z square into Az. Here, the charge q, this term, is completely replaced with the charge which has been q has been shown initially here. Q has equal to rho v into 4 pi a cube by 3. Now the term has completely changed to q. This is how we can get electric field intensity for different charge distributions. Thank you.